party time! Put down the clicker and pick up your liquor! It's time for Ed's Night Party! Starring me, Ed the Stock, and my co-host, the Anaconda, and featuring DJ James Stables! Tonight, usually the only women you see gagging on your television are porno stars working with Ron Jeremy, but singer Ashlee Simpson choked on national TV! And now she's talking to me backstage! See how quickly careers can recover?
Hey, that's some reception. Welcome to Ed's Night Party. What do you think of my outfit? You like it?
Slick. Very slick.
I feel like I should be like I'm at a country club or something on a Rockford Files episode. Like, no, it's okay. What do you think? Audiences are... All right, well, I'll tell you this. Regardless of what you think of my my top here, it's not going to compare to the top you're going to see coming down those stairs. Please welcome the lady behind the top, Leanna Kay. Leanna! Doing some inventory?
Did I stay in? Okay, good.
Yeah, don't worry. You would have heard if you hadn't stayed
hard
in.
Hard part over.
Yeah, nah, well, no hard part, just beginning.
I don't know if I could get more fetishistic than what's going on right now. I'm standing here in a corset with a phallic object.
Why am I an object? You start on the show, I'm an object.
You're on television, we're all objects.
All right, yeah. On that note, we'll move on. All right, so the professor, you may remember last show, was pissed off because his bike, his treasured bicycle, was stolen.
Last show was dramatic.
Yeah, his bike was stolen. It was taken right out of the parking lot.
Yeah.
It was the second one that was stolen. It was locked. It was taken. He has since then become the bane of security's existence. Every time you, my bicycle. I remember locking you here. I returned, and there you weren't. Where are you, bicycle? Are they treating you well where you are? All right, anyway, so every time he walks by security, he's like, hey, find my bike yet? And they, at this point, they want to f***ing take him into a room and beat the crap out of him.
That's what they before when they wanted to do that anyway?
Yeah, well, now they have a good reason. And I'm tired of hearing you whine. And I decided that rather than just being pissed off about hearing you whine and telling you to shut up, which never works because I've been telling you to shut up for years, I decided to do something about it to be proactive.
Awesome.
So I contacted a friend of mine. His name is Walter Posner. He owns the Cycle Path store at 2106 Yonge Street in Toronto, where the staff won't give you the gears, just fix them. And he's going to fix your gears. He has brought you a bicycle.
Are you nuts?
Walter, yeah!
Sweet ride. It actually matches my desk, actually.
What do you think?
Look at that.
That's sweet ass.
Look at that. That's nicer than the bike you had stolen.
I would say, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm delighted. Look at us.
All right, Walter, so is this like, I don't know anything about bikes, because once I got my my driver's license,
oh, there's like an ass vent in it, too.
What?
There's an ass vent in it. I don't know if you ride a lot of bikes, but your butt gets really sweaty. There's like a groove to siphon the water away from your crack.
Is that really? Walter, what's that about?
It feels good.
Yeah, that actually the purpose of that, isn't it?
It feels good.
I wasn't bullshitting. That's what it's for. Wow.
Ass vent? Like,
and it's thick, eh?
What?
I can't get my hand around that. That is a thick bike shaft.
Where are we going with this?
Professor, why don't you get out there?
I'm gonna watch this bike like a hawk. So if you see it on the street, I'm probably 5 meters away watching it.
All right,
make sure you got a good lock for it.
Yeah, that's the key, jerk.
Or sleep with it.
Don't give him any ideas. Oh, look at that.
Oh, now he looks like a retard. All right.
Whoa, he's moving.
Oh, dang. Where are you going? Walter, you want to run the DJ booth?
Yes.
Are you coming back?
Whoa, okay.
There he goes.
There he is. All right, Walter.
You don't deserve that bicycle.
I think you're going to join the psychopath team, so I'm going to present them. Take the shirt off my back and give it to him.
Oh! Look at that. All right. Oh, there he goes. Little drama.
Goodbye, Max.
Thank you, Walter. How about a hand for Walter?
Walter.
Oh. Is he coming back? Where is he?
I think he's humping the bike.
He's like the guy with the gas pump.
It had those pistons, man. I think he's just getting to know the bike. It looked like a stealth return. Guess who's back?
I'm right here.
Back again.
Yeah. Hey, Professor.
Yeah.
Where's the bike now?
Oh, shit. Hey, someone watch my bike. There's a security guy there, but...
All right. So we normally don't get any of this program captured for memories.
Never.
And I thought we need to get somebody in here.
Right.
Kind of like a police sketch artist.
A professional.
That's right.
A skilled master of his craft.
Are you done? We're going to get somebody in here to draw the proceedings so we have something afterwards to remember the show by. And we figured who better than our friend Sean Ward.
Yeah!
Sean Ward, latest edition of Electric Freakout Comics is on the stands. All right, so Sean, you're going to draw for us? You're going to draw our proceedings?
You got it, Ed.
All right, so we'll let you get... You look a bit like Rod Serling. All right.
So? These drawings are so good, they're going to put you in the zone, Ed.
Okay.
I'm telling you.
I don't know what zone that is.
Hey, draw my bike first. I want to...
Oh, Sean, we'll check in with you.
Oh, thank you.
All right, and while we keep the show moving,
yeah.
It's time to fulfill some more dreams. Not just James with his bike, but the dreams of some lucky viewer or viewers who get to be in the hot tub. And before we can put a guy in the hot tub, we need to first prepare the hot tub with our hot tub ladies. And in the hot tub today, we have Jen and Tina. Jen and Tina. Yeah?
I'm with my Tina Bombina.
Yeah, and my Jen Ben.
Yes.
Look at that.
I certainly hope the viewers at home appreciate the bathing suits the girls are wearing.
What?
Ow! Because apparently... Let's all get naked!
Yeah! That's the problem, is you like say that and nothing happens. You
know,
The comics, when they say Avengers Assemble, they lay the beat down on some bad guys. You say, let's get naked, and the show just moves on, everybody dressed.
James, sorry!
All right.
Because the more women you put on the show, the less important you become. You could sleep the entire f-ing show and no one would notice.
You never forget who brings you this little extravaganza every week at home.
All
right.
Thank you, Dad.
Yeah. Oh, Daddy's been bad. Yeah. Spank me. Okay. Now it's time to meet the gentlemen who are going to be in the tub. And it's not just gentlemen. In fact, they're not gentlemen. They're with a band. Please welcome...
I like band people.
Eye of Mourning. Joe. Hello, Marcus. Which one's Joe?
I'm Marcos.
Marcos, all right.
Hi, everybody.
Hi. Now, I understand you two aren't the only ones. You two aren't the only ones in the band, right?
No, we're not.
We have a couple other people coming out, and they're coming bearing gifts. And I do mean C-U-M.
All right.
Are they coming in, too?
Please welcome the rest of Eye of Mourning.
Wow, we got all these boys.
Oh, yes. Yeah, look.
Whoa. I feel like a fat kid in, like, a cake factory.
Or on the power play.
Wow, so tell me a bit about you guys.
We play an alternative style of music with classic rock vocals. Is that good for you, Ed?
Tells me nothing.
In honor of Eye of Morning, Debbie, our beautiful dancer over here, is showing her Crack of Dawn.
Yeah. How about a hand for Eye of Morning?
Woo! Thank you very much.
All right, and that brings us to my little calendar preview from the Rihanna K calendar.
It is.
And that outfit you're wearing is actually in the February picture.
Yep.
All right, why don't we take a look at the little flipbook sequence made from stringing together all the pictures that were taken to arrive at that one that wound up as the special February picture. Take a look. The idea was you were going to be eating a strawberry, like, you know, that whole being fed a strawberry.
Yes, yes, yes. It was kind of Garden of Eden-esque.
The idea originally was to have a chocolate-covered strawberry.
Okay, yeah,
remember?
You're right.
Now, of course, the problem was that we had to then make the chocolate covering.
Yeah.
And it didn't tend to go on quite as smoothly as we like. Do we have a picture of the chocolate-covered version, which didn't make it to the make the cut? Yeah.
Oh.
Rihanna didn't like that because she said it looked like it was covered with poo.
I'm trying to be sexier and you're giving me a strawberry dipped in shit. And I'm looking at this thing and it's like, smile. It's like, no, I'm revolted.
Go on. That takes a lot to revolt you.
Oh, it does. I think that looks very much like poo.
Anybody? Does that look like poo or chocolate?
Poo. That looks like poo, man.
I think it's on a strawberry, you gotta just think it's chocolate.
That is poo.
Alright, well, you got the regular strawberry.
Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's one for snackerscat.com.
And don't forget, of course, every week we give away a prop.
Buy the poo-free calendar.
Yeah, we give away a prop that Leanna used in shooting the calendar.
Yeah.
And take a look at the item that's up for you to win this week. From the calendar picture for August, the leopard print bathing suit that groped Leanna's breasts and crawled up her butt. This priceless artifact can be worn to the beach, displayed by your TV, or used to make soup. Order Leanna's calendar online now, and your name will be entered to win this unique and naturally scented piece of TV history. Go to edthesock.com. All right.
Congratulations,
all right.
Enjoy my cast-off shit.
Yeah. Hey, cast-off shit has its value.
Yeah. Cast-off shit, literally, with that strawberry.
Yeah. All right, let's go to a break while the girls experiment with their newfound gifts. And we'll be back after this on Ed's Night Party. Stick around. The female guest famous for what she did with her other pair of lips. I talked to newly blonde bombshell Ashlee Simpson. Plus, more aquatic antics with Tina and Jen and the band in the wank tank. So stay tuned. Hey, Ed heads! To get your hands on an exclusive signed Leanna calendar, Ed puppets, and other great crap, visit edthesock.com. Professor, did you take your bike out for a spin during the break?
Yeah.
And how does it feel?
It feels great. It's a good ride. Sweet ride.
Yeah, sweet ride. You know what else is a sweet ride? A car.
to ride like 4 minutes.
What if there's an emergency and they need someone to grab the wheel?
You know what
I think?
It's
gonna be me.
No, exactly.
I'll drive. I'll get in front of the wheel if you need me.
No, you get behind the wheel. In front of the wheel means you're on the hood. Kwame, my cigar. My cigar ran out. Can you?
Sure, get the one black one.
Well, you see, this is an issue. Okay, thanks, Kwame.
Kwame!
You see, I had a problem because before the show, like Kwame usually lights my cigar, and I'm calling, Kwame, can you come light my cigar? And I realized the optics of having the only black guy on crew here to light my cigar is just wrong. I said, you know what? The other guy who would do it, of course, is Barry. I said, send Barry. And then I realized, yeah, great. Send the Asian guy instead of the black guy. Is there any white people here who can do menial jobs for me?
Up next, Soft Shoe and Al Jolson tunes.
That's right. Kwame, how I love you, how I love you. Bye, Kwame. All right. You know, when I mentioned to Kwame that we wanted to have him stay with the show and move on to do floor directing, and I said, you know why we want that, don't you? And he said, yeah, because I'm a beautiful, dark-skinned black man. That's part of my original thinking, but hey, I guess you can't argue. We've got a lot of girls here who seem to appreciate it.
I'm not arguing.
Oh, really? Well, the two of you could make a website. Anyway,
Hey, if this doesn't work out.
This guy has like the nicest hair. Can we get a close-up look?
Really?
No, what the kind of show is this?
Are you think he's too? Top it all off? He's Latino. They call me Raul.
Yeah, Marco Suave. Good morning, if you're just joining us. They're a local band that plays some kind of alternative music. All right.
I think right now it's more like I have morning wood. Tina's been cooked.
I don't want to talk about the implications of you determining she's fish.
100% I'm humoring this bastard. I'm not. All
right. Yay, Tina Bobina!
For this week's Close Encounter, shall we? I admit it, I feel an affinity for Ashlee Simpson. After all, we've both had issues with lip-syncing. And it wasn't easy stepping out of her big sister's shadow, since her sister casts a large shadow in a couple of places. But Ashlee's no stranger to sex appeal. Her hit single, The La La Song, practically hits you over the head with its sexual lyrics, despite the use of the word La La in place of f***ing. So now that she's come of age, it was time to talk to me. All right, well, do I really need to tell you who I'm standing here with? Hello, Ashlee.
Hey, what's going on?
You know, for a long time I've admired you from afar because your people wouldn't let me get anywhere near you. But now that's all water under the bridge, and I'm glad to finally be standing here drinking in your presence.
Well, here we are.
Here we are.
Here we are.
And now that we're speaking in such airy tones, it was Charles Dickens who wrote, it was the best of times, it was the worst of times. That kind of describes your last year, sort of, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
But you know what? The media likes to talk too much about the bad times, and they're a bunch of vultures and parasites, and I never liked the taste of carrion. So let's talk about good things.
Let's
How about
do that?
That.
I would love to.
All right.
All right, what do you want to talk about?
Well, first of all, you're doing things with your hair.
Yes,
yeah.
I am.
You're back to the blonde?
You're doing things with your hair,
no, see,
too.
No, this is what I was going to tell you. See, this has been my color forever, and it's been very successful.
Right.
If you're thinking about, you know, changing colors, you want a different mood.
Right.
You know, what do you think? That would go well
green
with your
coloring. Green might look good on
me. What do you think?
Yeah, maybe so. Maybe next time I'll go green.
Yeah, are you duplicating me? Yeah, kind of.
Gosh.
What are you doing? What are you hitting me for? That's a little love tap. It's very
it was. It was a love rub.
Oh. Yeah. And speaking of love rubs, the La La song.
Right.
What's a nice girl like you singing about La La for?
I don't know. I just like to sing about La La.
Of course, you were promoting Safe La La.
Of course. Yeah. I don't even know. I mean, La La is just a fun term.
That's right. It could mean anything.
It could mean anything.
That's why euphemisms are so popular. What we should have done a duet, you and I.
Oh, of course.
Yeah, because my voice and yours, it's very different.
Right.
It's quite a mix.
It would be pretty good.
Don't you think?
Yeah.
You make me wanna la la la. What do you think?
Oh, I love it. Oh, yeah. My gosh. Maybe the remix.
Yeah. The whole way you've been shining me on. Hey, I got stuff for you, though. Just until we meet again.
Right.
I got a shirt for you. There you go. Who else gives you stuff, huh? You see, and you can wear that in your next video. And just to keep me close
I
to your heart.
I love it.
There you go.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. See, we're friends, right?
Absolutely.
That wasn't too bad, actually. Give me a hug, will you? No, you, no, the puppet. All right.
Oh, fine. I'll give you a hug.
Oh, thank you. That's it. Remember, I'm available. Just call me.
All right. All right. Bye.
Hey, Ed Heads. To get your hands on an exclusive signed Leanna calendar, Ed Puppets, and other great crap, visit edthesock.com.
Top or the bottom.
Don't try to dance in a corset.
All right, mark that down at home amongst the many things you've learned from this show.
What about Sean?
Oh, Sean, right. Sean's been drawing. I forgot. Sean Ward drawing our, what's going on? What have you done for us?
Well, I'm proud, Ed, to show this to you. This has been a lot of hard work to be the official court reporter for the show. Which camera am I playing to here?
Here we go.
Well, okay, this is Ed and Leanna, our co-host of the show. The stars, because it's the night party, right. And they are stars. The audience down the front here watching the show. And that's a beautiful thing right there. Here we got a shot of the scientists and Jenica and Debbie looking all pretty like they got. And the new bike right in the foreground. That's right. And last but not least, is we got a fantastic shot here of our beautiful girls. And I have wanted to see, this is only a 30-minute show. This is only a 30-minute show. I couldn't draw all of the members of Eye of Mourning, so we got an eye. You notice he's crying because he's mourning and there's sun in the sky. It is mourning. So hold these. I'm going to go over. I'm going to present this to our friends. Eye of Mourning over here.
Thank you, Sean. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, Ed.
All right. And like I always say, rather be a smartass than a dumbass. Remember anything good to say, say it often. Good night.